Adrian College Television would like to give a big thank you to our sponsor, Carlton Lodge of Adrian. Carlton Lodge is sponsoring all ACTV broadcasts during the 2021 to 2022 school year. Located at 1629 West Maumee in Adrian, Carlton Lodge offers comfortable rooms and suites at affordable rates. There's also a heated indoor and outdoor pool, along with a 24-hour fitness center. Thank you for the continued support toward Adrian College Television.
Crosses over, back onto the far side. Rips a shot, she scores!
I'm Matt Kibbe, the current student body president here at Adrian College. I chose AC because the campus simply feels like home. Everywhere I go, I know the amenities are there to help me succeed and get to the next level in my career. If you want to see what Adrian College has to offer, you can schedule an in-person visit at adrian.edu/campus-visit.
Adrian College has dozens of athletics programs, and winning is a staple on our campus. We have the culture of winning in and out of the classroom. This is a place where young men and women grow into professionals for life. Are you interested in learning more about the Bulldog experience? Visit AdrianBulldogs.com and the Recruit Me tab to be recruited to play your sport of choice today. If you have what it takes, you could be a Bulldog in no time.
Adrian College has once again been recognized for its commitment to engaged, experiential education by Colleges of Distinction, a one-of-a-kind guide for college-bound students. While higher education has changed over the past 20 years, Colleges of Distinction's selection process has stayed consistent in accepting only those that adhere to the four distinctions: engaged students, great teaching, vibrant community, and successful outcomes. Overlaid in the last few years have been a look into high-impact practices. They believe most critical to the student experience were the kinds of engaging experience that are found at Adrian College. To learn more, please visit adrian.edu.
Welcome to Adrian, Michigan. We're located in a proud college town. Adrian College is situated just 45 minutes from Ann Arbor, Detroit, and Toledo. We're very excited to show you just a little bit of what AC has to offer. This is the gateway to our campus. Welcome to the place that we believe will change the rest of your life. AC features one of the most well-rounded educational experiences in the country. We offer over 60 different academic majors and 10 academic institutes, as well as dozens of student organizations. Year after year, we've been ranked as one of the nation's best colleges, including being one of the most innovative institutions in the U.S. for our medical programs. Our campus is simply beautiful. Our student-to-faculty ratio is an incredible 13 to 1. That means more attention for you and a much better overall learning environment. We know how to put together an education that is life-changing, and these are just some of the highlights. From our communication arts program, to our many performing arts, to the home of business on campus, to our sciences and medical studies, we have the spaces where you can grow into the professional that you want to become. Our first-year student experience is award-winning. You'll make lifelong friends here, meet mentors, and maybe even meet that special someone. The Kane Student Center is open 24 hours a day, and there's a lot going on here. The Bulldog Beanery has all of your hot drinks. Pause and Go is our on-campus convenience store. The bookstore is where you'll get all of your Bulldog gear, and you can just hang out and study in the skyboxes. Not far away is the Shipman Library. The Shipman has quiet, relaxing spaces for you to study in. You can check out books from thousands of libraries around the country, and the Shipman is open 24 hours as well for your convenience. There are hundreds of learning opportunities on campus. In addition to the arts and beautiful facilities, Adrian College is known for its athletic programs. There is nothing like a Saturday game day here in Adrian. The Bulldog football team are 11-time MIAA champions. At Docking Stadium, fans watch soccer, lacrosse, football, and more. Just a few hundred yards away, Adrian College's basketball teams compete. In addition to basketball, fans can enjoy wrestling, acro and tumbling, and volleyball here. We also have a state-of-the-art weight room available to all of our students. When things heat up too much on campus, you can cool off with our ice sports. Our NCAA ice hockey teams are constantly battling in the national playoffs. Just a quick walk down the service drive, we feature one of the best baseball and softball programs in the nation at our level. Soon, you'll be able to cross the street and watch men's and women's rugby take to the pitch as well. Our rowing, crew and top-ranked bass fishing programs compete out of the Adrian College Boathouse, a gorgeous facility just a 15-minute drive north on Devil's Lake. Our students know how to relax in their downtime. When they're not out and about, we have dozens of housing options on campus. With apartments right in the mix of things, you can pick what works best for you. We've also recently renovated a few of our housing options. Adrian College is a Methodist-affiliated institution that has been changing lives since 1859. The modern liberal arts education offered by our faculty is unrivaled. We can't wait to have you on campus and show you around. Visit adrian.edu to schedule a full campus visit today. We'll see you soon.
What if you didn't choose to become an Adrian College Bulldog? Surely you would have carried on with your education and could potentially be graduating elsewhere. But what would you have the honor of greeting Bruiser on campus? Would you have had the privilege of working alongside faculty that know your name? Would you have had the opportunity to learn and grow in an environment that is seeking the truth and dignity in all people? Would you have had a creative learning environment that is supportive of challenging you and achieving excellence in your academics, but also your personal and professional lives? This has been Adrian College's promise to us. Just as our families have promised to love us unconditionally and support us through the many peaks and valleys of our lives, Adrian offered a similar promise to us when they realized our potential by asking us to join them. While we have been busy navigating the many what ifs of our time, none of which we could have imagined, we have indeed found the cane that holds our ribbons of excellence at Adrian to stand strong. Strength and tradition. A tradition that carries on from graduating class to graduating class. A symbolic reminder of the leadership carrying the motto, no victory without work. The Adrian College class of 2021 can proudly proclaim that we have earned our ribbon of excellence for persevering through a pandemic because of our hard work. We have had to learn how to best navigate the many what ifs in uncharted times. While some of the what ifs have been answered, it is now up to each of us to embrace and navigate on our own. What if I take that job? What if I decide to continue on for postgraduate endeavors? What if I decide this? What if I decide that? No matter what, you'll be able to face your tomorrow knowing that you are a member of a pack, the Adrian College Bulldogs Class of 2021.
Part of the family here at Adrian College are the friends we've made. These friends have gone to games with you, shared late night tales with you, explored downtown with you, and joked around with you at Ritchie. They are in the library with you at midnight, studying for the 8 a.m. exam you forgot to study for. And they're there when you cry because you failed that exam. These friends are your new family members now. You will stay in touch with them forever, even if it's just liking their Facebook post about the new puppy they just got. Parents, family, and friends, we cannot thank you enough for everything you have done for us. Thank you for the support and the opportunity for this moment to graduate from Adrian College. You have helped us reach our dreams and goals in life. Congratulations, class of 2021. We finally made it.
Adrian College has once again found itself on the 2022 U.S. News & World Report Best College Rankings. This is the eighth straight year that Adrian has been named to the Top Regional Colleges Midwest section. Adrian College was also named the most innovative school in the Regional Colleges Midwest category. In addition, Adrian received accolades in Best Value in Undergraduate Teaching within Regional Colleges Midwest. Adrian College was also named in the top first-year experiences by U.S. News & World Report. This marks the 13th consecutive year that Adrian has appeared in U.S. News & World Report. To see the full rankings, visit their website. For more information on Adrian College, visit adrian.edu.
The Adrian College Media Production House provides opportunities for students to learn and grow live on the airwaves, just like Matt Kibbe.
I've gotten a chance to create a relationship with coaches and teams and learn more from people instead of trying to teach myself something. Got an opportunity to expand my knowledge of sports, hone in on my skills as a broadcaster, and learn about equipment in different ways. You get more of a connection with professors as well.
Providing opportunities, growing leadership. The Adrian College Media Production House. Thanks for tuning in.
I'm Dejon Hughes, and I'm a senior in the class of 2021.
My name is Megan Abbey. I'm from the class of 2021.
Hi, my name is Caitlin Parisi, and I'm the class of 2021.
Wow. As far as working for ACTV, the first thing that comes to mind is honestly the community. Like, the people that I work with are amazing, all the way down from Jay at the top to the last guy that only gets to work one stream a week. It's just the energy that is around is always awesome.
It's a perk that you get free access to the games, but I absolutely love it. We have a great culture here, and then I was able to work my way up to a student director position, but I get so much creative freedom. I get to work in arenas and sports and environments that I absolutely love and enjoy.
ACTV has brought so many experiences and memories that I'll take with me to grad school and even beyond. It's been such a blessing to be a part of the team, and everyone's just so welcoming, and I've learned so much directing and using the camera and many other things.
If you do want to get into this stuff, I say do it, and do it quickly with ACTV, because not only is it a great community, but you'll also learn a lot and be prepared for the future.
I think what I'm going to miss most about ACTV that's not the free software that I get as a student would definitely be the people and the culture that we have here. Just the connections that I've made, the students that we have, just the family that we have here. I'm definitely going to miss everyone a lot.
I'm going to miss everyone, I think. Everyone's just been so great. I love the atmosphere. It's definitely another family away from home. I think directing is going to be something I miss, but just interacting with everyone during our meetings on Tuesdays, and just the atmosphere, I think, is going to be the biggest thing.
DJ, Megan, Caitlin, I know I told you this is going to be a promo about ACTV. Well, it's actually a promo about you guys. Your leadership as seniors has helped me guide the program since taking over at the beginning of January. I would not have been able to do it without you three. Now, I know your time is done with ACTV at the end of the semester, but I know you're going to do so many great things in your future endeavors. I wish you the best of luck.
Adrian College is looking for leaders, student athletes with the tenacity to keep the Bulldogs at the top, the forefront, in and out of the classroom. The Bulldogs are looking for talent, character, hard work, grit, leaders who can electrify sold-out crowds, gut out a last-line shift, will their team to victory, hit a grand slam in the bottom of the ninth, and be a part of a legend in the making. Think you have what it takes to become a Bulldog? Visit adrian.edu to learn more.
Adrian College is a pinpoint like no other. With our 77 undergraduate degrees, 47 majors, and 21 broad fields of study, Adrian has a one-of-a-kind, hands-on learning experience for everyone. Do you want to visit the campus of Adrian College in person? Visit adrian.edu/campus-visit. Again, that's adrian.edu/campus-visit. Come take in the beautiful facilities at Adrian College for yourself.
Welcome to Arrington Ice Arena. Good afternoon, hockey fans. Today, Adrian College hosts Kent State University in ACHA Men's Division III play. This game serves as the season opener for the Bulldogs, whereas the Golden Flashes enter the matchup holding a 1-2 record. Happy to have you with us here on Adrian College TV. I'm Calvin Keyes, riding solo up in the commentator's booth. Let's take a look at this afternoon's starters. For the Bulldogs, their forward core will consist of Evan Bliss, Antonio Briggs-Blake, and Matt Barucki. On defense, it'll be Dominic Somerville and TJ Anderson. Getting the nod in net is Rex Goldberg. For Kent State, their goaltender tonight will be Kevin Beauvais, accompanied by his teammates Ryan Kantner Alex Sanchez, the assistant captain, Luke Meyer, Captain Travis Sipple, Jordan Uranius, as well as Ed Miller. Happy to have you with us. Puck drop, and we're underway. Adrian in the black uniforms, Kent State in the gray, making the trip up from Kent, Ohio here tonight. Heading back for this one is Somerville. He'll rim it around the half wall. Briggs Blake in pursuit. Adrian trying to force it out, but they meet a roadblock, and Meyer is back in with the puck. Somerville, backhander will evade the D zone. Golden Flashes will chase back for it. Giving it a ride is Sanchez. Breakout pass is Arendt. Bulldogs send it back around the glass. Taking a check there to make a play is Carroll, who will get the puck back down low. Kent State moving forwards. Deflected onwards by Kantner as icing is waved. Back for it is Zach Bogotzi Jr. out of Allen Park, Michigan. Bulldogs looking for a way out as it bounces to center. Short of the captain, Ryan Pinho. Pinho just able to keep it in. Centering pass, a behind-the-back tip. Crafty play from Zach Major that is turned aside by the goaltender, Beauvais. Kent State looking to put together a breakout. Reversed here. Beats the Adrian forechecker all the way back down, and again, no icing. First minute of play here at the Arrington Ice Arena. Adrian College Bulldogs taking on the Kent State Golden Flashes. Sent wide, walking in. Pinho looking for the top shelf. He scores. Pinho pinpoints the top corner and makes it a 1-0 lead right off the hop for Adrian. Just a minute into the game as we take another look. Surging forward with it were the Bulldogs. Pinho got it on the right side circle and beat Beauvais to the blocker side to make it 1-0. Assist coming from Zach Bogotzi, the defenseman getting up on the rush and feeding it wide. Kent State will win this one back. Fumbled there by their defenseman, Dovenbarger. William Dovenbarger sending it up the wall, but only as far as Maximus Norwood. Gets it back down low. Adrian continuing to play in the O-zone. Blackmer sending it down. Sealing the boards there is Norwood. Centering pass was just behind Blackmer. Picking up the puck for the Golden Flashes is Corlew. Gets the puck deep. Out to play it is Rex Goldberg. Kept in at the blue by Van Sickle, but only momentarily. Bulldogs working forwards. Tripped up there is Nick Kirksey, and a penalty will be upcoming. Golden Flashes touch up. It's in the goal, but it's not going to count. What a shot that was from Ryan Kantner, but unfortunately there was a delayed penalty against his team. So going to the box now will be Giovanni Stelabots. And an unfortunate turn of events for Kent State, because that was a phenomenal shot from Kantner to beat Goldberg on the glove side. It went bar down, would have been a tie game if not for the tripping penalty booked against Giovanni Stelabot. Now an O-zone draw, first power play of the night will go to Adrian. Evan Bliss opposing Luke Meyer on the faceoff. It's tied up, still in that center circle. Controlled here by Somerville. He'll try a shot. That one sticked aside by Beauvais. Comes to Briggs Blake. Drop for Somerville, walking the blue, nicked off the glove of Beauvais. Into the corner. Evan Bliss returning to the point. Somerville, long shot, tipped in front. They score. That's two for the captain, Ryan Pinho. 2 goals, 2 minutes and 46 seconds into the game. We'll take another look on the replay. Power play is humming for the Bulldogs. Up top is Somerville, and a textbook tip from Ryan Pinho beats Beauvais with the deflection. So Kent State's penalty against Giovanni Stelabot for tripping comes back to bite them. As the Bulldogs are barking here early on, taking a hard check was Devin Bennett. Played back down into Kent State's zone again. Carrying it forward for the Golden Flashes is Volker. Saucers it deep. Goldberg will use the paddle to usher it down low. Adrian moving forward. Long pass sent away from his teammates by Evan Thomas. Adrian Bench making the petition that since Kent State's goaltender Beauvais left the crease to play at the icing should have been negated, and they have a pretty good case. But nonetheless, the faceoff will come back into the Bulldog zone, and actually now it will be taken to the center circle. That's an indication that the referees made a mistake, so shouldn't have called icing, but since they did, we will restart at center instead of in Adrian's own end. Bulldogs play it down. This time it is surely icing, without a shadow of a doubt. If you're just joining us, it's been a wild start. Ryan Pinho, the captain for the Bulldogs, senior out of Novi, Michigan. 5'10", 155-pound right wing with two goals early on in this game. Firing a shot off the draw there was Noah Volker, missed the net. Cleared out to neutral ice. Digging away at it is Curtis Clary. Back to retreat is Jordan Urenius with plenty of time. Feeds to the wing and Volker. Cross ice pass finds its way forward for Dries. Still Dries. Shot blocked aside there. Bulldog player getting in the lane. Still Dries. Keeps it himself. Poke checked away. Finds its way back to the defenseman. Shot is high and wide off the stick of Volker. Nice move by Evan Bliss through one. Leading returning scorer on this Bulldog team, but Adrian's struggling to clear it out right now. Golden flashes hemming them in their own ends. Puck squirts free now for Baruki. Uses the glass to his advantage. Bliss for Briggs Blake. Centering. Right pad stop by Beauvais. Smart play by Briggs Blake trying to generate the rebound. Evan Bliss will pursue the puck as it's taken forward by Cade Van Sickle. Finally settled down by Somerville. Banks it to the wide side of the sheet and down for another icing, something Adrian has had some troubles with so far in this game. Already three or four icing calls against the Bulldogs, pinning them in their own zone. 15-18 to go in the first period. Kent State have yet to generate their first shot on net. Adrian has had six so far and two goals. Calvin Keyes here with you on Adrian College TV. As the ACHA Men's Division III hockey team takes on Kent State. Shot through traffic, and Goldberg had to be on the top of his game as that shot from Travis Sipple, Kent State's captain, really had eyes on it, made a way through the crowd, and sealing up the ice well was Goldberg. Sophomore getting the start, native of Newton, Pennsylvania. Kent State plays it deep into the corner, where it will be rimmed around by Evan Thomas. And now onto the stick of a teammate. Firing a shot from the side there was Bogotzi. Pass is just a little bit behind Kantner. Regaining possession is Luke Meyer. Puck is pressured by Carroll. Carroll still giving Meyer some issues. He'll look to go D to D on here for Sipple. Travis Sipple. Building up some speed, angled wide by the Bulldogs. Centering pass didn't find the stick of a teammate. Kent State trying to keep it in. Taken by Bogotzi. Banked on along for Carroll. Adrian will skip this puck into neutral ice and get a change. Big hit laid by Bogotzi. Now Volker knocked off the puck. Race for it. Big check. That time, an Adrian player trying to poke it onwards. Working hard to try and get it is Thomas. Continues to move around the half wall. Finally makes its way to Ben Bloomquist at the point. Shakes loose an Adrian player. Heads down low. He is hit hard. Some knee contact there. And a penalty upcoming. Massive bodies down low. You wonder if it'll be a knee penalty coming up to one of the Bulldogs. Frustrated is Zach Bogotzi as he heads to the sin bin. The issue with that hit is he sort of came in a bit late and the leg caught the Kent State player, and tripping is the call. Bulldogs got a power play goal. See if the Golden Flashes can find one. Making the three-hour drive west here to Adrian, Michigan, up from Kent, Ohio, as clearing attempt heads into the Bulldog bench. Adrian led tonight by their head coach Justin Snyder in his first season, assisted by assistant coach Joey Patterson, also in his first year with the Bulldog program. Golden Flashes are coached by Miles Radicevich, and Andrew Radicevich is the assistant. Another big hit. Adrian player took the worst of it. Will Smith clattering to the ice. Bulldogs will send it down. Stelbots looking to work it across. Well-timed poke check there by Smith, but staying with the play is Stelbots for Kent State. Giovanni will send it across. Good job by Brining to tie up the stick of his opponent. Adrian will send it back down. No sustained pressure so far on the man advantage for Kent State. Sipple leaving it for Hammonds. Now Sipple skating ahead. Saucered down low. Picked up by Norwood. Chips one high and out, and maybe a chance here for Adrian. If they hurry, Zach Major speeding in. Major shoots, and it's over the crossbar. Bulldogs can't quite keep it in, and maybe a two-on-one the other way. Somerville will have to defend this. Rushes the shot, and they score. Clattering into the boards after scoring the goal is Riley Croson. Makes it a 2-1 game as Kent State cuts half the deficit. Great shot. Took a hit to score a goal. Bulldog defenseman wasn't quite able to keep it in. Set up a dangerous 2-on-1, and Croson was able to sneak the puck past Rex Goldberg on the short side. 2-1 hockey game. Kent State heading into this matchup with a 1-2 record. Lost to Miami, Ohio, 7-4 and 9-3 in their opening series. Then responded with a 4-3 win last weekend in Angola, Indiana versus Trine University. Fourth game of the year for them. For Adrian, it's their first contest. Winning the race to the puck is Kantner. Ryan Kantner heading in. Nearly a dangerous collision as it heads out in front. Good chance for Alex Sanchez that he was thwarted by Goldberg. Back up to the point. Dovenbarger through traffic. No rebound conceded that time from Goldberg, who hang on to the shot. Great save by Rex Goldberg, bouncing back after he allowed the goal on the previous play to Riley Croson. Faceoff upcoming in the Adrian zone. One back to the point where Volker will pick it up. Shot is blocked. Getting some applause from his teammates is Nick Kirksey. Gets in the way of it. Another save. Goldberg swallows it up. Pressure mounting for the Bulldogs as Kent State knocking on the doorstep of what would be the game-tying goal. Early on in the action here with 11:40 to go in the first period. Shots 7-5 in Adrian's favor, but they previously led 6-0, so run of play has recently gone towards the Golden Flashes. Brink wide pass, banked onwards to Steffel, acquired by Bogotzi. Delivers this one around. Hit hard, delivering the body contact with Stelbots. Knocked to the ground was Evan Blackmer, and tempers flaring here in the first. Picked up down low, sent in front. It'll skitter all the way back to the point, and Bloomquist, who does well to get the puck back out of harm's way and deep. Trying to bank it around with Smith. Blocking another shot was Kirksey. That's his second of the shift. Coming out to play the puck was Kevin Beauvert. Bulldogs will go back to retrieve. Hopeful pass sent towards the boards and turned over to Dreese. Andrew Dreese has the puck pickpocketed from him. Sent back down low. Chasing after this one is Norwood, trying to work the puck out, but Kent State will keep it in. Nearly halfway through this first period. Calvin Keyes here with you on Adrian College TV. Ryan Pinho's two goals give Adrian the lead over Kent State. Riley Croson scoring moments ago on the two-on-one rush. Penho's goals remarkably came in the first 2 minutes of the game. Great toe drag move, and Volker may be in here. Noah Volker! Grand theft from Rex Goldberg, making the save on Volker, who is in all alone. Norwood has it poked off his stick. Some disjointedness at the back end for Adrian's defenseman the past few moments of play. Huge collision. Getting knocked over there was Norwood. Trying to clear it out is Smith. Adrian can't quite. Another long shot that will be handled by Goldberg for the whistle. Frustration for Adrian as they're having a tough time breaking the puck out of their own zone. 9:23 to go in the first. Shots on goal now level at 7 apiece. Adrian Bulldogs, ACHA Men's Division 3 team playing their home opener as whistle will go on this faceoff. Players weren't lined up legally. Evan Bliss, top line center for Adrian, had some complaints about it. It was one forward yet again by Sanchez, who keeps it centered in front, and they score! Tie hockey game, thanks to the assistant captain, Luke Meyer. Take another look at this replay. Must have just trickled in on Goldberg. Picked up behind the net by Sanchez, and Meyer sneaks it through potentially the five hole of Goldberg. Just like that, it's a tie hockey game. Lots of scoring early on in the first period. Knotted up at 2-2 now. Batted in by Baruki. Bulldogs finally with some offensive zone possession after Kent State was buzzing around in their own end for the past few moments. Golden Flashes quickly break it out. Whacked forward by Baruki, but it will stay in play. Glove down by Briggs Blake. Sent across to Anderson. Tipped onward by Brining. Bliss turning, trying to center it out front. Couldn't quite connect. Good defensive play by Kent State. One-time drive from Somerville that goes wide and will clear the Kent State zone. Back to get it is TJ Anderson. Anderson circling, passes it to the wall, and his teammate trying to lead Briggs Blake has a stick knocked out of his hands. And penalty coming to Kent State. It'll be 2 minutes for slashing. Heading to timeout is Jordan Urenius. Knocked the stick out of Briggs Blake's hands. Bit of poor discipline there. And it warrants 2 minutes with an extra skater for the Bulldogs of Adrian College. Good turnout here on a Saturday afternoon at the Arrington Ice Arena. Can the Bulldogs give them more reason to cheer? Zach Major lost the faceoff. Played low for Brining. Back around the kick plate. Wedged forward by Krausen, who has one of Kent State's goals tonight. Krausen and Meyer so far for Kent State. Both of Adrian's goals coming from their captain, Penho. All the way down the ice, Edward Miller will touch up. And despite the fact that they're on the power play, Adrian commits an icing infraction. They've had a lot of them early on in this game. Looking to make a lot of stretch passes, but struggling to connect on them at the moment. Adrian's been brought back down to earth after a hot start, now being outshot by the visitors 8-7. Scored two goals in the first 2 minutes, and Kent State has quickly responded with two goals of their own. Carroll back to the point, and Bogotzi sent down into the corner. Banks around, puck back with Baruki to his defenseman. Baruki gets it back, plenty of space, looking rink wide. Pass could not be controlled by Major. Shot was deflected, taken away but not out. Back for Matt Baruki, centering feed off the chest of Beauvais and cleared away by Kent State. Another grade A opportunity for Adrian. Bogosi will allow the power play units to change. Trying to headman it for Pinho. Icing waved off for a deflection. Briggs Blake corralling it. Corner for Bliss. Antonio Briggs Blake looking across for Somerville, tipped in front. And Beauvais making the save on the deflection from Pinho. Had a nice tip earlier on in the game. Pinho now on two goals, looking for that elusive hat trick. Plenty of time to achieve it. 6:45 left to go in the first here from the Arrington Ice Arena. Somerville gets to the puck in time, keeps it inside the blue. Bliss, the assistant captain. Bliss had 23 points in 25 games last season, leading returning scorer for the Bulldogs. Fumbled by Somerville dangerously, able to recover, but Bulldogs will have to tag up and regroup. Heading back onto the ice is Jordan Urenius. Kent State back at full strength. Briggs Blake, the shot, high and wide. Anderson back to regain control. DJ Anderson, rink wide. Pass did not come off cleanly for Clary. Up the wall, finds Pinho, the captain, moving up ice. Into the Kent State zone, has it poke checked away from him. Bit of open space that Noah Volker will look to take advantage of, a low shot. Stop with the right pad of Goldberg, who will also stymie the follow-up. 5:37 left to go in the first. Adrian's men's D3 ACHA team is missing their top scorer from last year. It was Dominic Malone, who accrued 28 points in 22 games. Malone's strong performance earned him promotion up to the men's D2 squad that split a weekend series with Michigan. So Malone playing at the higher level now, so Bulldogs will need players to step up to fill some of that scoring void. Sent across by Owen Marks. Banked out. Good move, cutting it back is Bloomquist. Mark racing for it. Mark delivering a shoulder to his opponent. Sending it up the boards and out to the neutral zone. Collected by Steffel. Over for his partner, Bloomquist. Ben Bloomquist pinched to the half wall, but will send it deep for Urenius. Trying to work it out front. Comes back into the near corner. Hard hit was laid that time by Devin Bennett. Still Adrian cannot clear the zone. Struggling on the breakout. Mark lays a big check, still getting back up on his feet. Finally, the Bulldogs send it down, but it's on net, so no icing. Beauvais in miscommunication with Sipple. Dumped in deep by the Golden Flashes. Coming loose now for Luke Meyer. Loses it. Evan Bliss holding off an opponent. Now Bliss with some speed. He's outnumbered. Plays it through the stick of his opponent. But knocked down by the glove of Beauvais. Skips out of the zone. And a chance here. Speeding onwards is Kantner. Ryan Kantner right into the Adrian text on Goldberg's sweater. Another stop for number 32. Played his junior hockey, played high school hockey with Council Rock North in the state of Pennsylvania. He's a bit of a smaller goaltender, standing at 5'7", but he's looked big so far in this game. Adrian tied with Kent State 2-2 in the late stages of the first period. Looking to usher it aside. Golden Flashes have had a lot of sustained ozone possession as that goes off the knob of Goldberg's stick and into the fishing net. This game, the second of three consecutive hockey matchups on Adrian College TV. One back by Kent State, fumbled momentarily by Goldberg before leaving it for Anderson. Chips it off the plexiglass and a race for it. Coming forward is Zach Major, slots it five hole. Major helps the Bulldogs retake the lead as he puts it between the wickets of Beauvais. Puck squirted out, bounced perfectly on for Zach Major, right between the legs of Beauvais, and he's feeling himself. Zach Major, the senior out of Dearborn. Huge goal. See if Adrian can carry the lead into the break. Top line heads back out for the Bulldogs. Went up 2-0 to start the contest. And Kent State responded with a pair of goals. And now Zach Major with the third goal of the night for Adrian makes it a 3-2 game. Puck finds its way to Kantner, centered in front, and the shot sails just wide from Meyer. Stick knocked away by Somerville from a Kent State player. Turning, firing that time was Bloomquist. Shot deflected wide, and Bloomquist will regain the puck at center. Knocked in by Kent State. Taking his time is Anderson. Looks rink wide for Somerville. Saucer pass that couldn't be knocked down by Briggs Blake. Beauvert came out of the net but didn't touch it. And that's the argument that Adrian head coach Justin Snyder is making right now, that icing should be negated. We saw earlier in this game Beauvert came out to play it, and the referee called icing but adjusted it to a center ice draw. This time it will go all the way back in Bulldog territory. Adrian had the first six shots of the hockey game, now outshot 14-11. 2:54 left to go in the first period. Glove down and held in for a moment by Sippel. Ed Miller backhanded onwards. Big hit by Briggs Blake. Knocks over an opponent and perhaps a chance here. Unable to get a clean shot off is Austin Bryan as he was mobbed by a couple of golden flashes. And Beauvert will cover off. 2 minutes, 38 seconds separating us from the first intermission. Goals for Adrian from Ryan Pinho. Two from him, and the latest coming from Zach Major. Kent State scoring two, courtesy of Krausen and Meyer, as leveled that time was Smith down on the near wall. Centered on, trying to find the puck here is Adrian. Finally cleared out by Kent State, and they're off to the races. Spinorama pass that is cut out well. Getting in the way of it are the Bulldogs. Send it down. Should be icing. Back referee's arm was up, but his partner didn't get the memo, so play will continue. Interesting turn of events there. We've had some issues with icing so far tonight. Squirts out for Krausen. Shot saved by Goldberg, and also gets in the way of the follow-up. Golden flashes, possessing, banking down low. Sanchez returning it for Krausen, who's hit hard. Still tangled up with Bogotzi. Another save, Goldberg. Adrian desperately needs to clear. And this time it will be icing. Buck 26 left in the first period. Adrian College Bulldogs sported a 12-11-2 record last season, 11-3-1 against men's Division III ACHA opponents. They were ranked 24 in the country going into the MCHC playoffs, but fell frustratingly 6-2 to Central Michigan in the first round of the postseason tournament, ending their campaign. Looking for more this year. Missing one of their top players, Dominic Malone, but Evan Bliss returns. Brian Pinho has made an impact early on in the home opener. He'll backhand it in now. Sent around the wall by Urenius, a chance. Shot coming from Major, who had the third goal of this hockey game. Ryan Kantner eating a slap shot in the final minute of play now as Kent State will center it onwards. Luke Meyer trying to move it by Smith. Wasn't having any of it. A ripper will head over the bar off the stick of Urenius. Bloomquist has it poked away, now regains and snatched up by the catching mitt of Goldberg. 40 seconds left. Pinho having a conversation with the official. Something he felt needed to be noted. Draw in the Bulldogs' end. Kent State with one last chance to level the score if they can win it cleanly off the draw, but Adrian will get the better of the Kent State centerman. Evan Bliss racing. Turns on the brakes, through the legs pass to Briggs Blake, stopped with the left pad of Beauvert. Looking to move it into the middle. Staying with it is Bliss. Forechecking onto the puck. Breakout pass was too far away from Corlew. Somerville driving wide. Skips by a potential checker. Bliss shot from a tough angle. Sealed off by Beauvais. Final several seconds of play. Briggs Blake trying to score a buzzer beater. Instead, Beauvais will make the stop. And that's how things will stand going into the first intermission. 3-2 lead for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Have the advantage over the Kent State Golden Flashes. We'll return for second period action here on Adrian College TV in about 15 minutes. Stay with us.
Crosses over, back onto the far side. Rips a shot, she scores!
What if you didn't choose to become an Adrian College Bulldog? Surely you would have carried on with your education and could potentially be graduating elsewhere. But what would you have the honor of greeting Bruiser on campus? Would you have had the privilege of working alongside faculty that know your name? Would you have had the opportunity to learn and grow in an environment that is seeking the truth and dignity in all people? Would you have had a creative learning environment that is supportive of challenging you and achieving excellence in your academics, but also your personal and professional lives? This has been Adrian College's promise to us. Just as our families have promised to love us unconditionally and support us through the many peaks and valleys of our lives, Adrian offered a similar promise to us when they realized our potential by asking us to join them. While we have been busy navigating the many what-ifs of our time, none of which we could have imagined, we have indeed found the cane that holds our ribbons of excellence at Adrian to stand strong. Strength and tradition. A tradition that carries on from graduating class to graduating class. A symbolic reminder of the leadership carrying the motto, no victory without work. The Adrian College class of 2021 can proudly proclaim that we have earned our ribbon of excellence for persevering through a pandemic because of our hard work. We have had to learn how to best navigate the many what-ifs in uncharted times. While some of the what-ifs have been answered, it is now up to each of us to embrace and navigate on our own. What if I take that job? What if I decide to continue on for postgraduate endeavors? What if I decide this? What if I decide that? No matter what, you will be able to face your tomorrow knowing that you are a member of a pack, the Adrian College Bulldogs Class of 2021.
Part of the family here at Adrian College are the friends we've made. These friends have gone to games with you, shared late night tales with you, explored downtown with you, and joked around with you at Ritchie. They are in the library with you at midnight, studying for the 8 a.m. exam you forgot to study for. And they're there when you cry because you failed that exam. These friends are your new family members now. You will stay in touch with them forever, even if it's just liking their Facebook post about the new puppy they just got. Parents, family, and friends, we cannot thank you enough for everything you have done for us. Thank you for the support and the opportunity for this moment to graduate from Adrian College. You have helped us reach our dreams and goals in life. Congratulations, class of 2021. We finally made it.
Welcome to Adrian, Michigan. We're located in a proud college town. Adrian College is situated just 45 minutes from Ann Arbor, Detroit, and Toledo. We're very excited to show you just a little bit of what AC has to offer. This is the gateway to our campus. Welcome to the place that we believe will change the rest of your life. AC features one of the most well-rounded educational experiences in the country. We offer over 60 different academic majors and 10 academic institutes, as well as dozens of student organizations. Year after year, we've been ranked as one of the nation's best colleges, including being one of the most innovative institutions in the U.S. for our medical programs. Our campus is simply beautiful. Our student-to-faculty ratio is an incredible 13 to 1. That means more attention for you and a much better overall learning environment. We know how to put together an education that is life-changing, and these are just some of the highlights. From our communication arts program, to our many performing arts, to the home of business on campus, to our sciences and medical studies, we have the spaces where you can grow into the professional that you want to become. Our first-year student experience is award-winning. You'll make lifelong friends here, meet mentors, and maybe even meet that special someone. The Kane Student Center is open 24 hours a day, and there's a lot going on here. The Bulldog Beanery has all of your hot drinks. Pause and Go is our on-campus convenience store. The bookstore is where you'll get all of your Bulldog gear, and you can just hang out and study in the skyboxes. Not far away is the Shipman Library. The Shipman has quiet, relaxing spaces for you to study in. You can check out books from thousands of libraries around the country, and the Shipman is open 24 hours as well for your convenience. There are hundreds of learning opportunities on campus. In addition to the arts and beautiful facilities, Adrian College is known for its athletic programs. There is nothing like a Saturday game day here in Adrian. The Bulldog football team are 11-time MIAA champions. At Docking Stadium, fans watch soccer, lacrosse, football, and more. Just a few hundred yards away, Adrian College's basketball teams compete. In addition to basketball, fans can enjoy wrestling, acro and tumbling, and volleyball here. We also have a state-of-the-art weight room available to all of our students. When things heat up too much on campus, you can cool off with our ice sports. Our NCAA ice hockey teams are constantly battling in the national playoffs. Just a quick walk down the service drive, we feature one of the best baseball and softball programs in the nation at our level. Soon, you'll be able to cross the street and watch men's and women's rugby take to the pitch as well. Our rowing, crew, and top-ranked bass fishing programs compete out of the Adrian College Boathouse, a gorgeous facility just a 15-minute drive north on Devil's Lake. Our students know how to relax in their downtime. When they're not out and about, we have dozens of housing options on campus. With apartments right in the mix of things, you can pick what works best for you. We've also recently renovated a few of our housing options. Adrian College is a Methodist-affiliated institution that has been changing lives since 1859. The modern liberal arts education offered by our faculty is unrivaled. We can't wait to have you on campus and show you around. Visit adrian.edu to schedule a full campus visit today. We'll see you soon.
Working on the plot and the scheme, the true stock trademark is at the edge of your dreams. I'm talking one. One shot for the kill, the breeze cut, freeze up, straight dropping the chills. I'm talking. Taking over pieces and shares of all big sky high, check the movement is here. Yeah, yeah. It's one heart, one shot, now the future is yours. Go!
The Adrian College Media Production House provides opportunities for students to learn and grow live on the airwaves, just like Matt Kibbe.
I've gotten a chance to create a relationship with coaches and teams and learn more from people instead of trying to teach myself something. Got an opportunity to expand my knowledge of sports, hone in on my skills as a broadcaster, and learn about equipment in different ways. You get more of a connection with professors as well.
Providing opportunities, growing leadership. The Adrian College Media Production House. Thanks for tuning in. Adrian College is looking for leaders, student athletes with the tenacity to keep the Bulldogs at the top, the forefront, in and out of the classroom. The Bulldogs are looking for talent, character, hard work, grit, leaders who can electrify sold-out crowds, got out a last-line shift, will their team to victory, hit a grand slam in the bottom of the ninth, and be a part of a legend in the making. Think you have what it takes to become a Bulldog? Visit adrian.edu to learn more.
Fans connect with Adrian College TV on social media to be updated when we're broadcasting live, to see highlights, plays of the week, and much more. Adrian College Television is on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. ACTV's handle is at Adrian College TV on every form of social media. Thank you for tuning in and subscribing to the home of the Bulldogs, Adrian College TV.
Adrian College is a pinpoint like no other. With our seven.
Welcome back to Arrington Ice Arena. Second period action just moments away. ACHA Men's Division III Hockey. Adrian College hosting Kent State University and the Bulldogs' home opener. That first period had a lot of action. Adrian taking a 3-2 lead here into the second. Take a look at our first period goals. Ryan Pinho got the first and second goal of the night. First was unassisted. Second was a power play goal assisted by Dominic Somerville. Then Kent State answered back with a power play goal of their own from Riley Croson, and then followed it up with an even strength goal from Luke Meyer assisted by Alex Sanchez. Then Zach Major regained the lead for the Bulldogs. And guess who? Ryan Pinho with the assist. 3 points for Pinho in the first period alone. Shots on goal fairly even. Kent State with the slight edge, 17-16. Both teams have been good on the man advantage. 50% effectiveness for Adrian. 100% rate for Kent State. And decent saves numbers through one period for both goaltenders. Rex Goldberg had 15, and Joe Beauvair had 13 as puck drop approaches here in the second period. Bliss facing off with Luke Meyer. Meyer winning it back to his defenseman, Miller, who will turn and fire it forwards. Race back for it is Thomas. Backhanded over to his D partner, Briggs Blake, skipped over his stick, trying to stay with it, is the sophomore out of Oxon Hill, Maryland. He'll drop it back for his defenseman, Bogotzi. Thomas's pass is picked off and sent back into the far corner by Kent State. Pokes forwards, cross-ice pass, Miller connecting with Sanchez, who had an assist in the first period. Racing back for it is Thomas, squirts out in front. Can be collected by Volker, who fires it right into the glove of Goldberg. Seconds into the second period, score remains 3-2 in favor of Adrian. Kent State bringing a 1-2 record into the game, and Adrian playing their first contest tonight. Second of a triple header here on Adrian College TV as it skips out of the zone. Pinho had 2 goals in the first. Can he add another? Tries his best, but Beauvair will stonewall him with the glove. As I was saying, triple header here today of hockey action on Adrian College TV. Started off with a ACHA men's D1 matchup against Roosevelt at 1 p.m. Now we have this game. It'll be followed by women's D1 action. Bulldogs hosting the 18U girls prep team of Culver Academy to open their season. Saw several of the Culver players warming up during the first intermission. Kent State flying out of the zone. It's Kraus in the shot high and wide. Had a goal in the first. Can't generate a repeat performance off the 2-on-1. Racing back for it is Bloomquist. Bumped into by Pinho. Pass forward for Urenius. Jordan Urenius crosses over center and dumps it deep. Colliding there with a Bulldog player. Sent to the half wall. Backhanded all the way down by Brining. And icing called. Adrian Bench furious because Cade Van Sickle really delayed on the way to chase down that puck in hopes of the icing call, and his tactics paid off. Back in the Adrian zone. Nick Kirksey wins the draw against Steffel. Whacked high in the air. Bulldogs trying to find it. Picked up by Kirksey. Plays it in deep to Chase. Misses the body check. Picked up on the wall by Adrian, centered in front. And a chance there, shot from the defenseman, Will Smith. And Beauvair will catch it easily. Early on in the second period here from Arrington Ice Arena. These two teams will play again tomorrow in Kent, Ohio, 540 puck drop to finish the home and home series. This game still in question. Bulldogs with a slight one goal lead. Pass is picked off by Luckhart. Sends it back in deep. Clary trying to find it. Instead comes for the golden flashes. Van Sickle just outside the zone. Bogotzi will dump it back in deep. Collected by Dovenbarger. Evades a check. Dovenbarger looking forwards. Pass didn't come through cleanly, but still finds its way to Luke Meyer. Had one of those first period tallies for Kent State. Breakout pass will slide through undetected. Chipped back out by Bogotzi. Collected by Thomas. Sends it all the way down, a race for it. And Miller gets there first for the icing call. Adrian continues to send it down the sheets, having some trouble connecting passes and breaking the puck out of their zone. Most of their goal scoring chances have come off the rush, off of defensive breakdowns from Kent State. One to the far wall. Briggs Blake digging at it. Back down for Bogosi. Bennett pinching on the near wall. Comes for Devin Bennett, who's pressured. Fires it deep. Sipple acquiring the puck. Banks off the glass. Bliss trying desperately to keep it in. Knocked back the other way by Bogotzi. Kent State pass finds its way to Thomas. And now we'll squirt out onto the stick of Volker. Sliding in to cut him off was Bogotzi. A great play by the defenseman that upended Noah Volker. Stoppage in play. As looks like perhaps the puck may have gone out. We'll have to see. Kent State taking the draw. Tied up in the faceoff dot. Sent around the boards. Banked by Urenius. Picked up here by Zach Major, who had the third goal of the game for Adrian so far. Norwood acquires the puck. Looks to Carroll on the wall. Pinching to keep it in is Urenius again. Chopped forward, and a break here for Zach Major. Major in on goal. Missed it. Up in the netting. Thought perhaps it would be deja vu for Zach Major. Scored from a similar position in the first period, but he has no such luck. 15:49 left in the second period. Shots even at 19 apiece. Draw coming here. Can't be cleanly won by either team. Sitting there in the dot, trying to come in to shoot was Blackmer. May have nicked off the glove of the goaltender Beauvert. Centered in front dangerously. Blackmer a chance. That was blocked away. Scramble for it. Beauvert covers and look to slide it out of the zone. Tangle of bodies as we get the whistle. Still mixed up here is Kirksey with a Kent State player having to be separated. And it looks like they're going to take Kirksey here for a penalty. Appears perhaps could have been unsportsmanlike conduct against Kirksey. Power play upcoming for Kent State. It was a case of Kirksey just not leaving the premises around the goal quickly enough. Seemed to have a word for multiple golden flashes, and perhaps for the referee, likely the main reason why he's in the penalty box now. Bliss and Briggs Blake conversing along with Baruki. Changes being made in personnel. Power play unit heads out for Kent State. Penalty is not on the clock, as I suppose we'll continue 5-on-5. Wonder if maybe it's a 10-minute misconduct penalty for Nick Kirksey. Center is in the penalty box for Adrian right now, but nothing up on the board, curiously enough. We stay even strength at Arrington Ice Arena. Evan Bliss, skate to stick, plays it wide to himself. Bliss turning backwards. Ed Miller caught a piece of Bliss. 3-on-2 for Kent State. It's dished wide. Trying to center there was Kantner. Instead, it may be a rush the other way. Bliss speeding after it. Being angled to the boards. He'll be hit hard there. Booming contact from Meyer. And a penalty coming up to Kent State now. Alex Sanchez in the box. This one will go up on the board. Adrian power play coming up. Man advantage will get another chance to operate after going 1-for-2 in the first. Bliss will take the draw against Krausen. Knocked backwards. Winning the race to it here is Krausen. He'll chip it up out of danger. Pinho behind the goal will settle things down and look to orchestrate the breakout for Adrian. Carrying it onwards is Somerville. Deflected in by Antonio Briggs-Blake. Bloomquist on the wall with it. Dug free by Bliss. Pass was nearly deflected aside by Volker. Instead, they'll continue possession. Anderson out front. They score. Ryan Pinho. Here come the Hats. That's 3 for the captain. Bulldogs make it 4-2. Some of the fans up in the Wow Cafe and Wingery contemplating throwing their hats down, but decide against it from the looks of things. 4-2. Ryan Pinho had 2 goals in the first, finds his 3rd for the hat trick. Cade Van Sickle weaving forward, takes a check. Kicked up by Stellabots. Kent State goes offsides. So after scoring the first 2 goals of the game and then being answered by Kent State, Bulldogs back in front by 2 thanks to Ryan Pinho's 3rd of the night. The captain leading by example tickles the twine once again. Kent State centering it out front. Could not be controlled by Stellabots. Speeding away with it is Bogotzi. Banks off the window. Bover out to play it. Rims it around. Sealed off by Brining. Back down low. Big hit. A double D on there against Kenton Carroll. Sent in low. Took an odd bounce off the boards. Kent State will continue their puck pursuit. Poked onwards. Wrapping it around is Brining. Kept in by the Golden Flashes. Puck heads into the far corner. Trying to backhand it out is Adrian. Chips this one high in the air. Sipple will let it soar over his head and down for the icing call. Ryan Pinho getting some applause for his hat trick goal. 4-2 here in favor of the home side, Adrian, with 12:50 to go in the second period. Bulldogs versus Golden Flashes. Kent State coached by Miles Radicevic. Adrian coached by Justin Snyder, who has to be pleased with the performance of his captain. The senior right winger, Pinho, Novi native. 3 goals so far on the night, maybe more to come. Bogotzi has it stolen from him by Kantner. Back out to the points. Sipple bumping it into the middle, just outside the blue now for Kent State. Sends a high flip back behind the goal of Rex Goldberg. Controlled at center, dumped right back in. Taken by Evan Thomas. Adrian can't quite get it out. Thomas will head back yet again. Banks it behind the goal to his D partner. Bogotzi with some room to skate it. Plays it through the legs of a Kent State player. Still it's Zach Bogotzi. Fires a shot. Wide to Beauvais' right. Big check laid there by Major. Major collision with Meyer. Smith composing himself. To the far wall. Bogotzi all the way down. Bulldogs win the race. It's behind the cage. Trying to poke it home was Briggs Blake. Squirts loose. And a cross-checking penalty upcoming. Looks like it'll be the captain, Travis Sipple, the perpetrator. Two hands to the back of a Bulldogs player. 4-2 lead for Adrian. And a chance to widen the margins with an extra skater for the next 2 minutes. One back cleanly. Bulldogs passing it around. Skips over the stick of Baruki, and Kent State clears it down. Held by the paddle of Goldberg. Bogotzi picks it up. Major for Bogotzi. Plenty of space. Gains the zone. Slows it down. Feeds Baruki centered in front. Trying to tip it home was Austin Brining. Point shot again. Right pad stop by Beauvais with a Bulldog right up in his grill. Kent State harbors the puck out to the neutral zone where Bogotzi will allow the power play units to change. Leaves for Briggs Blake. For Bliss. Pinho already has a hat trick tonight. Can he find another power play marker? Plays it behind his back to himself. Speeding forwards with less than a minute to go in the man advantage for Adrian. Pinho fires. It's off the outside of the goal. A bit of an optical illusion there. Kent State trying to clear. Ryan Pinho sliding in. Doing everything possible to try and keep it in the zone, but unsuccessful. Somerville picks up the puck and snaps a pass up for Anderson. 20 seconds left in the penalty to Travis Sipple. Point shot well wide off the stick of Somerville. Kent State clears. Ethan Steffel pays the price. Goldberg being pressured, plays it to the near wall, up for Somerville, backhanded through the legs of Briggs Blake, could not be controlled. Kent State back at full strength now, sticked aside by Beauvais, and a race for it now. Sipple, the captain, has the puck on his stick from an acute angle, lofts that one extremely far out of play, always difficult with the puck on edge in that manner, tough to control and keep the shot down. Score still stands 4-2 in favor of Adrian. 9:21 left to go in the second. Luke Meyer loses the draw. Blackmer races to it. Kicked forward soccer style by the Kent State defenseman. Dropped backwards dangerously. Gloved by Goldberg off the chance from Sanchez. .908 left to go in the second period. Calvin Keyes here with you on Adrian College TV. ACHA men's D3 action. Adrian College versus Kent State University. Our director tonight, Andrew Black, serving us well. Picked up behind the net by Sanchez, centered out in front. Dribbles away from the crease, but only as far as Sipple. Ushers it back down low. Comes to Goldberg, who will smother. Only prior encounter between these two schools was a two-game series played in 2020. Adrian dominated, taking both games by scores of 7-2 and 7-1. Up 4-2 right now, but it's been pretty close affair. Lots of quality chances for both sides. The strong play of Ryan Pinho has been the difference as puck will soar into the netting. Another reminder that following this broadcast, we'll have more hockey, this time shifting gears to women's hockey here at Arrington Ice Arena. Women's ACHA D1 takes on Culver Academy 18U team. That shot from Krausen ramps off of Adrian's stick. Pinho clears it. Racing after it is Major, who already has a goal tonight. Urenius Krausen onto the stick of a teammate. Leveled there is Bloomquist as he attempted the shot. Backtracking for it is Carroll. Loses it. A chance and a brilliant shot block from the defenseman Bogosi. Bogosi playing it around now. Hustling after it and absolutely decks Ryan Lustig. Chance in front, right in front of Goldberg. Got a piece of it with the glove. Kent State possessing here in the O zone as taking a punch to the face there was Bogosi as he tried to lay a hit there on his opponent, Noah Volker, who steals the puck now. Volker walking in. Goldberg had to be good. Second shot misses the frame. Adrian desperately needs to get it out, and they will here. Sloppy line change for the Golden Flashes, and it'll head deep into their own zone. Stretch pass up for Stellabot as much-needed fresh legs head on for Adrian. Fighting that shot off is Goldberg. Contains it for the faceoff. 7:21 to go in the second period. Again, if you're just joining us, you've seen three goals from Ryan Pinho for Adrian, as well as one from Zach Major. Goals for Kent State attributed to Riley Croson and Luke Meyer. Bulldogs came out hot, scoring two goals in the opening 2 minutes of play. Briggs Blake will take this draw. Backhand chance, finds the stick of another Kent State flash, and diving to make the stop is Rex Goldberg. Denying Jason Corlew right on the doorstep. Goldberg continues a strong play. Needs a bit more help from his defense as Antonio Briggs Blake to take this face off. Tied up at the dot. Tap to the near wall. Sent behind the Adrian net. Ice has been tilted in Kent State's favor, yet they still trail by a score of 4-2. Dovenbarger makes a trip all the way around the kick plate to Van Sickle. Briggs Blake. Somerville. Briggs Blake couldn't hold it up on the wall. That shot from Dovenbarger is deflected. Poked forwards. Adrian trying to muscle it out of their own zone. Still Kent State will keep possession. Looking to center it into the slot. Briggs Blake tripped up, colliding with his own teammate Bliss. Somerville takes a hard check. Bulldogs desperately need to clear this puck. Tired legs on the ice for them again. Somerville will settle it down. Passes it over for Anderson. Finally lofted out just outside the zone. Kent State dumps it in again. They'll get fresh legs on the ice. Forward unit changing for the Bulldogs. Using the window well, there is Somerville. Angled in for Clary to chase. Nick Kirksey still in the penalty box after, I think it was the 10-minute misconduct penalty for unsportsmanlike conduct. Penalty is not up on the board, so I think he'll return at the next stoppage after 10 minutes time has played. Dangerously sent in front of the net by Luke Meyer. Back out to safer pastures. Backhanded forward by Miller. Dealt across by Smith dangerously. Smith the stretch pass that ramps off a stick, bounces off the netting, and gloved well by Briney. We'll see a whistle and a neutral zone draw in a few moments. 5:23 to go in the second period as Nick Kirksey is released from his stay in the penalty box. able to return to the bench. After he was booked early on in the game. Brian Pinho bounces off the skate of Garrett Carroll. Chip shot forwards. Kent State reacquires it. Ben Bloomquist up the left wing. Trying to thread it through a skate. Can't force it through, being locked up by Will Smith. Smith knocks over Bloomquist. Kent State will play it back to the point. Andrees. Andrew Drees chipped up. Takes a check. Kent State keep it in. A chance here. Stick lift coming from Carroll. Timely. Shot tipped wide. Picked up by Krausen. Still right in front of the Adrian goal. They've been trapped in their zone numerous times tonight. Still somehow have maintained a two-goal lead. Poked forward. Major couldn't get there in time. Turning is Norwood. Falls onto his backside. Pinho in deep. Cade Van Sickle acquires the biscuit. Bogosi forward onto the stick of Urenius, who's pressured. Adrian trying to create an offensive zone presence, following up Kent State's effectiveness in the Bulldogs' end. Battled for along the glass. Backhanded forward, could not be controlled by Corlew. Holding it in briefly was Thomas. Now Kent State will head forwards. A nice shot block. Bogosi eating the puck, coming off the stick of Corlew. Bulldogs up 4-2 as it's sent dangerously across. Surprised Goldberg a bit. And this one will head down off the stick of Baruki. Icy. Touched up by Stellabots. Good crowd on a Saturday afternoon at the Erenton Ice Arena. Calvin Keyes here with you on Adrian College TV. Happy to have you with us. Part of our ACHA hockey triple header. Crowd getting pumped up here at the AIA. Bogosi. Given some trouble by Stellabots. Briggs Blake run into by Dovenbarger. Still Kent State keeps it in. If anyone needs a little bit of pumping up right now, it's Adrian. Been a bit lackluster, struggling on the breakout so far. Briggs Blake will lob it out. Forward by Van Sickle. Briggs Blake dealt to Thomas. Through the middle of the ice, evaded the stick of Brining. Kent State picking it up. Back out to the neutral zone. Briggs Blake playing it in as a couple of players tangled up down low. Austin Brining having a bit of a disagreement with Sipple, but it's Kent State back up the other way. Missing the one-time chance was Nate Owen. Bulldogs trying to get it out. Brining looking to return the favor with Sipple, who will walk to the middle of the ice. Nate Sipple a shot off a leg in front. Picked up here by Jake Luckhart. Luckhart one-on-one with the defenseman, has it stick checked away. Adrian with another opportunity. That was Pinho on the follow-up. Has a hat trick tonight. Pass sent into the body of Owen. Kent State back with control. Dancing in is Sanchez, knocked away. Pinho backhanded forward, and maybe Zach Major is in here looking for his second of the night, and he finds it. Zach Major makes it 5 on the board for Adrian College. Gets these fans inside Arrington Ice Arena on their feet. Most of the goals for Adrian tonight have came off of these breakaway chances off the rush. And Major, again, will roof it over the glove hand of Kevin Beauvert. Zach Major, 2 goals. Ryan Pinho, 3. 5 goals for Adrian in this game. All coming from the likes of just 2 different players. It's been remarkable because Kent State has dominated possession. They've had the puck for extended periods in the Bulldog zone, haven't been able to finish as much as they would have liked. As it's sent across here, a chance. Bogosi trying to clear it away. Pinho, he's tripped up as it's gloved down by Urenius. But as I was saying, Kent State had lots of sustained possession, but no end result. And then they've been caught on some poor line changes and defensive breakdowns that have sent Adrian on breakaways and odd man rushes, which has provided them with their five goals here tonight. Pursuing the puck is Major, who scored moments ago. Taps it to himself. Zach Major. Beauvais got just enough of it. What a moment that would have been. Puck up into the netting. Major, senior out of Dearborn. Both of the guys on the second line pitching in, the center Major and the right winger Pinho, both hailing from the Detroit area. Major from Dearborn, Pinho from Novi. Hockey is a big deal in Detroit. Somerville missing the net. Hockey hotbed in the United States of America. Miscue here, and perhaps a 3-on-2 for Kent State. Looking to center in front. Dries had his stick tied up. We'll have another stoppage as it exits the rink. 48 seconds left to play in this second period. So far, this game has not disappointed. Bulldogs have two goals, as we just mentioned, from Zach Major, three from Ryan Pinho. And for Kent State, they have scored two goals in the first period. Bliss nearly was off to the races again. Briggs Blake around the kick plate. Kent State keeps it in, centered in front, and directed away with the blade of Rex Goldberg's stick. Shots even at 25 apiece. Bulldogs have the three-goal advantage with 34 seconds left in the second. Meyer versus Major. Zach Major wins it back. Nice move there from Bogosi, leading Pinho. Pinho tied up, stays with the play, centered in front, and they score. Will Smith slaps it into the back of the net off of a great effort from Pinho to stay with the play. That is now 5 points for Ryan Pinho. Three goals, two assists. What a performance so far by the senior, setting up his buddy Will Smith. Pinho, the resilience to fight off an opponent. And then Will Smith snuck in on the back door, says hello to the crowd. Kent State has to be a bit crestfallen. Lots of chances. Scoring opportunities have been even, but Adrian has had the more clinical finishes, leaving this second period late with a goal from Will Smith. First goal of this game scored by a player not named Zach Major or Ryan Pinho. Golden Flash is clear forward in the waning seconds of the second period. Bulldogs up by four heading into the break. Adrian leads 6-2 at home at the Arrington Ice Arena. Calvin Keyes here with you on Adrian College TV. Stay with us for third period action in about 15 minutes. We'll be right back.
crosses over, back onto the far side. Rips a shot, she scores!
What if you didn't choose to become an Adrian College Bulldog? Surely you would have carried on with your education and could potentially be graduating elsewhere. But what would you have the honor of greeting Bruiser on campus? Would you have had the privilege of working alongside faculty that know your name? Would you have had the opportunity to learn and grow in an environment that is seeking the truth and dignity in all people? Would you have had a creative learning environment that is supportive of challenging you and achieving excellence in your academics, but also your personal and professional lives? This has been Adrian College's promise to us. Just as our families have promised to love us unconditionally and support us through the many peaks and valleys of our lives, Adrian offered a similar promise to us when they realized our potential by asking us to join them. While we have been busy navigating the many what ifs of our time, none of which we could have imagined, we have indeed found the cane that holds our ribbons of excellence at Adrian to stand strong. Strength and tradition. A tradition that carries on from graduating class to graduating class. A symbolic reminder of the leadership carrying the motto, no victory without work. The Adrian College class of 2021 can proudly proclaim that we have earned our ribbon of excellence for persevering through a pandemic because of our hard work. We have had to learn how to best navigate the many what ifs in uncharted times. While some of the what ifs have been answered, it is now up to each of us to embrace and navigate on our own. What if I take that job? What if I decide to continue on for postgraduate endeavors? What if I decide this? What if I decide that? No matter what, you will be able to face your tomorrow knowing that you are a member of a pack, the Adrian College Bulldogs Class of 2021.
Part of the family here at Adrian College are the friends we've made. These friends have gone to games with you, shared late night tales with you, explored downtown with you, and joked around with you at Ritchie. They are in the library with you at midnight, studying for the 8 a.m. exam you forgot to study for. And they're there when you cry because you failed that exam. These friends are your new family members now. You will stay in touch with them forever, even if it's just liking their Facebook post about the new puppy they just got. Parents, family, and friends, we cannot thank you enough for everything you have done for us. Thank you for the support and the opportunity for this moment to graduate from Adrian College. You have helped us reach our dreams and goals in life. Congratulations, class of 2021. We finally made it.
Welcome to Adrian, Michigan. We're located in a proud college town. Adrian College is situated just 45 minutes from Ann Arbor, Detroit, and Toledo. we're very excited to show you just a little bit of what AC has to offer. This is the gateway to our campus. Welcome to the place that we believe will change the rest of your life. AC features one of the most well-rounded educational experiences in the country. We offer over 60 different academic majors and 10 academic institutes, as well as dozens of student organizations. Year after year, we've been ranked as one of the nation's best colleges, including being one of the most innovative institutions in the U.S. for our medical programs. Our campus is simply beautiful. Our student-to-faculty ratio is an incredible 13 to 1. That means more attention for you and a much better overall learning environment. We know how to put together an education that is life-changing, and these are just some of the highlights. From our communication arts program, to our many performing arts, to the home of business on campus, to our sciences and medical studies, we have the spaces where you can grow into the professional that you want to become. Our first-year student experience is award-winning. You'll make lifelong friends here, meet mentors, and maybe even meet that special someone. The Kane Student Center is open 24 hours a day, and there's a lot going on here. The Bulldog Beanery has all of your hot drinks. Pause and Go is our on-campus convenience store. The bookstore is where you'll get all of your Bulldog gear, and you can just hang out and study in the skyboxes. Not far away is the Shipman Library. The Shipman has quiet, relaxing spaces for you to study in. You can check out books from thousands of libraries around the country, and the Shipman is open 24 hours as well for your convenience. There are hundreds of learning opportunities on campus. In addition to the arts and beautiful facilities, Adrian College is known for its athletic programs. There is nothing like a Saturday game day here in Adrian. The Bulldog football team are 11-time MIAA champions. At Docking Stadium, fans watch soccer, lacrosse, football, and more. Just a few hundred yards away, Adrian College's basketball teams compete. In addition to basketball, fans can enjoy wrestling, acro and tumbling, and volleyball here. We also have a state-of-the-art weight room available to all of our students. When things heat up too much on campus, you can cool off with our ice sports. Our NCAA ice hockey teams are constantly battling in the national playoffs. Just a quick walk down the service drive, we feature one of the best baseball and softball programs in the nation at our level. Soon, you'll be able to cross the street and watch men's and women's rugby take to the pitch as well. Our rowing, crew, and top-ranked bass fishing programs compete out of the Adrian College Boathouse, a gorgeous facility just a 15-minute drive north on Devil's Lake. Our students know how to relax in their downtime. When they're not out and about, we have dozens of housing options on campus. With apartments right in the mix of things, you can pick what works best for you. We've also recently renovated a few of our housing options. Adrian College is a Methodist-affiliated institution that has been changing lives since 1859. The modern liberal arts education offered by our faculty is unrivaled. We can't wait to have you on campus and show you around. Visit adrian.edu to schedule a full campus visit today. We'll see you soon.
crosses over, back onto the far side. Rips the shot, she scores!
What if you didn't choose to become an Adrian College Bulldog? Surely you would have carried on with your education and could potentially be graduating elsewhere. But what would you have the honor of greeting Bruiser on campus? Would you have had the privilege of working alongside faculty that know your name? Would you have had the opportunity to learn and grow in an environment that is seeking the truth and dignity in all people? Would you have had a creative learning environment that is supportive of challenging you and achieving excellence in your academics, but also your personal and professional lives? This has been Adrian College's promise to us. Just as our families have promised to love us unconditionally and support us through the many peaks and valleys of our lives, Adrian offered a similar promise to us when they realized our potential by asking us to join them. While we have been busy navigating the many what-ifs of our time, none of which we could have imagined, we have indeed found the cane that holds our ribbons of excellence at Adrian to stand strong. Strength and tradition. A tradition that carries on from graduating class to graduating class. A symbolic reminder of the leadership carrying the motto, no victory without work. The Adrian College class of 2021 can proudly proclaim that we have earned our ribbon of excellence for persevering through a pandemic because of our hard work. We have had to learn how to best navigate the many what-ifs in uncharted times. While some of the what-ifs have been answered, it is now up to each of us to embrace and navigate on our own. What if I take that job? What if I decide to continue on for postgraduate endeavors? What if I decide this? What if I decide that? No matter what, you will be able to face your tomorrow knowing that you are a member of a pack, the Adrian College Bulldogs Class of 2021.
Part of the family here at Adrian College are the friends we've made. These friends have gone to games with you, shared late night tales with you, explored downtown with you, and joked around with you at Ritchie. They are in the library with you at midnight, studying for the 8 a.m. exam you forgot to study for. And they're there when you cried because you failed that exam. These friends are your new family members now. You will stay in touch with them forever, even if it's just liking their Facebook post about the new puppy they just got. Parents, family, and friends, we cannot thank you enough for everything you have done for us. Thank you for the support and the opportunity for this moment to graduate from Adrian College. You have helped us reach our dreams and goals in life. Congratulations, class of 2021. We finally made it.
Welcome to Adrian, Michigan. We're located in a proud college town. Adrian College is situated just 45 minutes from Ann Arbor, Detroit, and Toledo. we're very excited to show you just a little bit of what AC has to offer. This is the gateway to our campus. Welcome to the place that we believe will change the rest of your life. AC features one of the most well-rounded educational experiences in the country. We offer over 60 different academic majors and 10 academic institutes, as well as dozens of student organizations. Year after year, we've been ranked as one of the nation's best colleges, including being one of the most innovative institutions in the U.S. for our medical programs. Our campus is simply beautiful.
Welcome back to Arrington Ice Arena. Third period action just moments away. Adrian Bulldogs, ACHA men's D3 team, currently commanding a 4-goal lead up 6-2 against Kent State University. Take a look at our second period goals. Ryan Pinho got the hat trick goal, assisted by Thomas Anderson and Evan Bliss early on. Followed it up with another goal from Zach Major, assisted by guess who, Pinho. And then finally, to cap off the period, Will Smith got on the board, slapping it into the open net, assisted by Pinho. So as things stand, Ryan Pinho, the Bulldogs captain, 3 goals and 3 assists so far on the outing. Not bad. Here's our stats through two periods on your screen right now. You can see the shots on goal fairly even. Kent State with a lot of sustained possession, but they've given away some costly turnovers, causing odd man rushes and breakaway chances for the Bulldogs, who are also 2-for-3 on the power play. They've been disciplined, only giving Kent State one opportunity. You see the 12 penalty minutes for the Bulldogs because Nick Kirksey got booked for a 10-minute misconduct that did not give a power play to Kent State, but he was out of the game for 10 minutes in the second. Saves are fairly even between the likes of Beauvais and Goldberg as we have our third period puck drop. Golden flashes, dump it in, as rubbed out along the boards is Kantner. Still looks to be down for the count, tangled up with Antonio Briggs Blake. Kent State working in. They'll play it down low, back up to the point. Matt Zalasko through traffic, stopped by the right pad of Goldberg. Rex Goldberg with 23 saves so far tonight. Evan Bliss speeding ahead. He's tripped up, shockingly no call. Much to the discontent of the Bulldog bench, head coach Justin Snyder asking some questions, but Bliss stays with it. Off the floor and on the board, Evan Bliss. Number 7 scores goal number 7 for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Just 43 seconds in to the third period. And the hill to a comeback becomes even steeper for Kent State. Ryan Pinho and Zach Major have led the way, and Will Smith and Evan Bliss have followed as Bliss beats Kevin Beauvais, who will glove it this time, holding on to the puck. Beauvais handing it off to the official as we'll see an ozone draw. Evan Bliss, the assistant captain, Adrian's leading scorer from last season, scored as dangerous giveaway there. Blomqvist lost his bearings on the puck, slid into the crease of Beauvais, who had no choice but to lay on it for the whistle from the referee. Major, 2 goals tonight. Could we get 2 hat tricks in the same game? We would if Major scores again in this third. That would be quite the turn of events. But now Kent State looking to make their own luck. That was far wide from Riley Croson, who has one of Kent State's 2 goals tonight. Golden Flashes struggled to start off the season, falling heavily to Miami, Ohio in both games of their first weekend series. Bounced back with a close win in OT against Trine, and now looking to come back in this game, down by 5 goals against Adrian. Somerville blocking the shot. Heads behind the crease of Goldberg. Muscled along the siding. Pinho works it out. He has been superb tonight. 6 points tonight. 3 goals, 3 assists. He's been a part of 6 out of the 7 Bulldog goals in this game. Ladies angled forwards onto Kirksey, who missed out on 10 minutes of play in the second due to a misconduct penalty. Battling down low for it now. He's tripped up. Arm does not go up in the air. Kirksey is still slow to get back up onto his feet. Kent State will send it all the way down the sheet. Battled for. Owen Marks getting in on the fray. 6'5", 260-pound freshman out of Ann Arbor, Michigan. Certainly carries a lot of weight and a big hit there that he laid down on the far corner. Will Smith, and he scores. Might have been deflected. Smith dancing around as looks like he may have gotten his second of the game. The hard work from Owen Marks in the far corner sets up an offensive chance for the Bulldogs. Have another look. Came out for Smith. Shot was high. A little bit out of frame. May have been tipped, but the Bulldogs were all pointing towards the defenseman, the junior Will Smith, and all signs point to that being his second goal of the night. So three Bulldogs with multiple goals makes it 8-2. Norwood, D-to-D, Bogosi. Sent in deep, caught by Beauvais. Evan Bliss talking to the ref right now, the assistant captain. Had a goal there seconds after being tripped. Seeing a couple of tripping penalties be ignored by the ref. Didn't matter for Bliss, though. He got right back up and scored. Kent State clears it out. Bulldogs attempting to move it back in. Devin Bennett will get it deep. Held in well by Bogosi. Long shot. Sliding across and fielding it is Kevin Beauvais. Another whistle. Good pressure to start the third after Adrian was hemmed into their own zone for a large part of the second period. Answering back here early. 16:56 still yet to play in this third period. It's been all Bulldogs. Up 8-2. Ushered around by Urenius. Trying to tip it down was Croson. Puck bouncing around with great frequency. Moving down low is Dries. Still pinned to the wall. Puck finally escapes out to neutral ice. What's banked on for Croson. Smacked away by Somerville. Turned over. Picking it off is Garrett Carroll. Carroll staying with the play. Kent State trying to clear it out. But they can only get it as far as Pinhoe. Pinhoe a high stick negated since Kent State got the next touch on the puck. Volker moving by one. Now checked to the glass here by Anderson. Anderson and Volker still tied up. Trading shoves as Kent State a couple of whacks at it in front. And Goldberg will prevent Giovanni Stellabot as he has numerous attempts at the cage. Players still gathered in front. Stellabot having a word with numerous Adrian players. More good chances for Kent State. Frustrating night so far. I think the message going into this third from Miles Radicevich was likely more of the same. They had lots of good opportunities in the second. But the play of Rex Goldberg has stood out between the pipes for Adrian. Not the start that Kent State had dreamed up going into this one as the shot is blocked. Racing after it here. Bulldogs trying to get to it. Taken down there was Luckhart. Looked like he was hacked and tugged down. Still will stay at even strength. Bogosi will settle it. Kent State still needs to tag up. Skating it forwards, gaining the red line. Has it stolen from him. Stellabot. Right back for Baruki. Bogosi, the defenseman, getting up ice. Being hooked, has a stick stolen from him. Has to resort to soccer methods as a delayed penalty coming up to Kent State. Stellabot will touch up. And a holding call coming up against the Golden Flashes. Bogosi was able to keep possession for his team momentarily despite being dispossessed of his twig. Making the shameful trip to the box right now is Ed Miller. Always a lonely road into the sin bin. 15:07 left in the third. Another power play for the Dogs. Already up 8-2. Kent State whacks it forward quickly. TJ Anderson across here. Somerville stumbling. Still able to direct the puck forward. Back across for Pinho. Onward for Bliss, who had a goal so far in this third period. Drops it back for his teammate, TJ Anderson. The defenseman carrying it below the nets. Turned it over. Knocked down ice by Kent State, and Adrian will have to regroup. Quick hands there from Somerville. Rushing forward from behind the red line that's sent in, but it is on goal, so no icing coming up. Adrian will change defenseman. Zach Bogosi goes back for it. Right-handed junior defenseman out of Allen Park, Michigan. Fumbled for a moment. Picks the puck right back up. Finds Briggs Blake. Still Briggs Blake. Trying to poke it free in front was Carroll. And Golden Flashes will steer this one down again. Goldberg to leave it for Bogosi. Less than a minute remaining in the penalty to Ed Miller for holding. Adrian gets the zone entry. Walking in, chance in front. Baruki trying his luck. Denied by Beauvert. Back for Baruki. Up top, Bogosi loading up. Deflects high and into the mesh. And Garrett Carroll lending a helping stick to the referee. Hands it off to him with 26 seconds left on the Bulldog power play. Adrian in the black uniforms tonight. Kent State rocking the gray. Across, shot is wide of the mark from Carroll. Walking the blue is Bogosi. Finds Baruki. Down low, Brining. Baruki tipped in front. It is saved by Kevin Beauvert. Shove given by Jordan Urenius onto the backside of Brining. 13:11 left to play in this third. Bulldogs leading over the Golden Flashes 8-2 as Ed Miller prepares to exit the box in 4 seconds time. Draw one back, one last opportunity. Norwood sending it wide, still in front, right in front of the crease. Norwood stepping up, didn't miss by much. Smith looking for the hat trick. Two players on two goals as it's played across. And I think the final touch, tough to tell who had it. It looked like it was Devin Bennett as a scuffle ensues here after the goal. Devin Bennett, the freshman right winger. Another look at this. Puck was pinballing around. An astute play by Curtis Clary to knock it across the blue paint. Got tangled up with a Kent State player in the aftermath. Looks like that's the first career goal for the freshman, Devin Bennett. Right winger out of Woodhaven, Michigan. Gets the goal, and you can see how excited his teammates were for him. 9-2, Adrian. Bulldogs swarming right now. Referee having a word in the scorekeeper's booth, and now play will resume. Played through the feet by Brining. Sent across in front. Chance tipped. Careening off the left pad of Beauvert. Now battled for on the near wall. Finding it is Kantner. Looks across the sheets. Played onwards by Kent State. Goldberg will leave it there gingerly for his defenseman. Back down low, Will Smith. Two goals tonight. Lofted up by Norwood. Stick checked aside by a Golden Flash defenseman. Van Sickle uses the boards. Icy negated. It's ruled that Kantner got a piece of it. DJ Anderson. Saucered over. Tipped in by Carroll. Just past the red line. A hard hit on a Kent State player and a penalty upcoming to Garrett Carroll. Might have been more of an instance where William Dovenbarger, who took the brunt of the contact, kind of lost his footing, which made the hit look worse than it was. But nonetheless, Garrett Carroll heading for an extended stay in the penalty box. Still a bit frustrated. He'll be called for boarding. Carroll being consoled by the healthy scratches right above us in the press box. 2 minute power play for Kent State. Down by 7. Can they start to attempt a comeback in this game? Upended is Bogosi. Golden flashes keep it in. Racing after it is Steffel. Ethan Steffel in the corner, settling the play down. Pace slows here as they find Urenius at the point. Sent across. Urenius trying to knock it down. Bouncing pass. Bogosi logging a lot of minutes tonight for the Bulldogs. 11:20 to go in the third period here on Adrian College TV. Kent State on the power play right now, trailing 9-2. Shot is blocked by Pinho, the captain. In the corner with it is Steffel, biding his time. Looks behind the goal. Banked up top for Riley Krausen. Returns it low. Kent State looking rink wide, wide open. On the back door was Urenius. Couldn't control the pass. Came in hot. Bliss trying to clear. Gets a stick to it, but not enough. Krausen back down low. Fought for. Volker returning it to the point. And Van Sickle, less than a minute left in the power play for Kent State as they control the run of play. Trying to tap it on frame was Sanchez. Now it will come to the stick of a Bulldog player who sends it the length of the ice. Kent State looks to forge forwards again. Smith picking it off. Chipping up for Brining to chase. Finding it is Kantner. Dances into the far corner, dropping it back. Speeding forward to pick it up is Sipple. Played across, walking in, and the shot from Meyer deflected up and out of play as Garrett Carroll will make his return to the ice after serving his boarding minor. 9:50 left in the third period. Bulldogs leading 9-2 over Kent State here at ACHA Men's D3 Action. Great sportsmanship from Garrett Carroll, having a word with Alex Sanchez, who I think he knocked over on that previous play that warranted the boarding call. Probably stating those weren't his true intentions to knock him to the boards in a violent manner like that. Adrian's chasing after it now. Out shooting Kent State 37-26. Puck rolling down the ice on edge. Tough for a defenseman to corral, but Travis Sipple will try and do so. Luke Meyer picks it up. Around the kick plate. Pinho turning. Delivers it deep. Kent State trying to poke it forward. Pinho back to the point. A shot through traffic and a goal from Zach Bogosi. He's worked hard tonight, and hard work pays off. Kevin Boebert had no sight lines on that shot. Look at the crowd of humanity as that went towards the goal and went past the glove hand of Boebert. Adrian hits double digits. Thanks to the efforts of Zach Bogosi. Good things happen when you put the puck on net. Been singing Bogosi's praises tonight. The alternate captain for the Bulldogs has made lots of great defensive plays. Now he makes a big offensive play. Physical play here on the near wall. Players continuing to get tangled up, and we'll have a penalty. Should be against Adrian here. Tripped up is Luckhart. Heading to the box, Devin Bennett. scored his first career goal earlier on in the night. It'll be a cross check against Bennett. Another Kent State power play upcoming. These two teams will face off again tomorrow at 5:40 p.m., this time in Kent, Ohio. About 180 miles east of Adrian, three-hour drive. 8:53 to go in the third. Ozone draw to start the Golden Flash's power play. Comes out to the point, deflected off the skate of Brining. Battled for along the end wall. Right side of the ice. Luke Meyer back for Sipple. Low shot, careened through. Goldberg may have gotten a piece. So this is now airmailed down the length, a race for it. Sipple being pressured. Bovera, an ill-advised lofted pass across that may have been able to have been batted down, but escapes through. Cross ice pass, a shot here, and that is blocked well by Bogosi, who scored moments ago. Stelabot to the point. Back low by Krausen. In front, Riley Krausen. One goal tonight, caught in the paraphernalia of a Bulldog defenseman. Back out in front, sliding in again is Bogosi. A couple of shot blocks on this shift for him. Less than eight to go in the period. Less than a minute to go on the Kent power play, as we'll see another penalty, and this time it'll be against the Golden Flashes. That'll cut their power play short. Making the trip to the box is Ryan Kantner. Another cross-checking call. So we'll have four-on-four hockey for 54 seconds, and then a minute and 6 seconds of Adrian power play time after that. Ice will open up a bit here for four-a-side hockey. Bogosi, another point shot. Why not try it again? Off the post. Deflected off Bovaire, off the iron, and out. He's had lots of luck from that same position. Third time's the charm, not in this case. Kevin Bovaire scoops it up. Another reminder to stay with us here on Adrian College TV, ACHA Women's Division I Hockey. Their home opener as they take on Culver Academy, U18 prep. High-level travel team. Making the trip here to face the Bulldogs. Puck drop for that one at 7 p.m. right here on Adrian College TV. Thomas pasted to the wall. Squirts out onto the stick of Urenius. He has open ice to skate it. Jordan Urenius, great move, trying to elevate on Goldberg. Put it between the legs of Thomas. Couldn't quite put the cherry on top. 7:04 left in the game and 11 seconds to come of 4-on-4 until Adrian will move to the power play. One forward by Kent State, sent out in front. Could not be shot cleanly by Volker, another chance. Well wide off the stick of Bloomquist. Returning to the game is Bennett. Heading to the bench. Blackmer will head onto the ice. Chasing this one down is Thomas, the defenseman with plenty of time. Good crowd tonight on a Saturday afternoon at Arrington Ice Arena. Bulldogs have put on a show, up 10-2. Top performance has been from their captain, right winger Ryan Pinho. 3 goals, 3 assists for a total of 6 points. Not a bad way to open up the season if you're number 20. Cross-ice pass was just missed by Blackmer. Fed across and forwards. Disjointed play in their own end for the Bulldogs. Picked up by Corlew. Isolated. He'll look back out to neutral ice and his teammate Van Sickle, who banks it back into the grasp of Anderson. The freshman playing on the first pairing tonight for the Bulldogs is... This one ramps out of play. Three fives left on the score clock, 5:55 left in the third. 10-2, the lead for Adrian College. Van Sickle gives the puck a ride. Max Norwood to Briggs Blake. Team's back at even strength now. Norwood, backhanded forward. Van Sickle staying with it. Defenseman hopping up into play, but not before Norwood collided with him, bumps him off the puck. Baruki looking for a way out. Circles back again for Anderson. Coughed it up. Controlling here, and a nice move, a shot coming from Sanchez. Has an apple tonight. Big block there, and Sanchez checking to make sure Norwood's okay after that puck hit him in an awkward region. Circling around now is Kent State, cross ice feed. Meyer back in. Anderson pressured. Looks to find Brining, who mishandled it. But staying with it now is Zach Major, looking for the hat trick. Pinched to the corner by Sipple. Looking to move backwards. Sipple giving Brining a rough ride. Brining plays it behind him. On for Major, the alternate captain. Pinho marks the shot. Low glove save made by Kevin Beauvert as Zach Major did his best to get out of the way. 4:28 left in the hockey game. Bulldogs dominating the Golden Flashes at the moment. Kent State remarkably was able to come away with a 4-3 OT win over Trine last Saturday. They were heavily outshot throughout the game, 50-27. Jason Corlew tied the game up with 2:23 left on the clock, and then Ryan Kantner scored for them. The game winner, 2:50 into sudden death OT. Chance here for Sipple. Swing and a miss. Adrian looking to clear. Goaltender Bradley Hammonds made 47 saves in goal for Kent State that evening. Sent across here. A chance. Shot from Bennett, blockered up into the air. Kicked away. That's going to draw a crowd as tension's growing. Bennett knocked down to the ground. He's going to remind Kent State of the score that's up on the board. 10-2, if you're wondering. Both teams still having words. 3:58 left in the contest. Barring something extraordinary, Adrian will win their home opener to improve to 1-0, and Kent State will fall to 1-3 on the season. Briggs Blake coming on late. Puck finds its way to him now. Adrian tags up, heads back in on the forecheck. Cleared out. Glove down by Will Smith. Passed across for Evan Thomas. Squeezes by. Finds the near corner. Extra shove given by Bloomquist. Still keeping Kirksey on the ground. Nick Kirksey will have to be on his best behavior. Already took a 10-minute misconduct call in the second period. He's been more mild-mannered since then. Now he'll step up, delivers a hit. May have taken the worst of it. A cross check from behind coming from Stellabot. I wonder if that one wasn't called. Interesting. Stellabot moving in now. It's loose in the blue paint. Kent State swarming. Adrian clearing. Long shot. Deflects off the glove of Goldberg and saves this one from in tight. 29 saves tonight for Rex Goldberg. 2 minutes, 56 seconds away from securing his first win of the year. Newton, Pennsylvania native, the sophomore, has impressed. Kent State with quality chances, but only two goals. Looks like we will have a timeout. Both teams will make the return to their benches. Adrian College will call time and will step aside for a brief moment back for the remaining 3 minutes in a second.
Bulldog fans connect with Adrian College TV on social media to be updated when we're broadcasting live, to see highlights, plays of the week, and much more. Adrian College Television is on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. ACTV's handle is at Adrian College TV on every form of social media. Thank you for tuning in and subscribing to the home of the Bulldogs, Adrian College TV.
Back on Adrian College TV, out of the timeout, Adrian with a D-zone draw, up 10-2. Story in this game has been Pinho, as we've mentioned at great length. He has the hat trick and three assists. Two other Bulldogs sitting on two goals right now. That's center Zach Major and defenseman Will Smith. It would be remarkable if either of them could find another Geno late on. That would make it two hat tricks in the same game, which is, I don't know if I've ever seen that in a hockey game. So that would be a momentous occasion. Several of the Adrian ACHA women's D1 players looking on from nearby the Kent State bench. Getting ready for a 7 p.m. puck drop against Culver Academy. That one right here on ACTV. It'll be myself, Calvin Keyes, accompanied by Alex Herman. Got a great crew this evening. Working this game, Andrew Black is directing. Maybe a path as the Red Seas part for Dries. He's knocked over. As we were saying, our director's Andrew Black. Cameraman is Chancey Boyce, doing a bang-up job. Pinho, puck pursuit. Elevated by Dovenbarger. Norwood is still without a stick, trying to shield it away. And the Kent State player is Maximus Norwood. Scrambling for it down on the ice, and whistle will blow for a lengthy stoppage in play. $1.50 left in this one. Good crowd watching tonight, both from the bleachers and from their perch up in the WOW Cafe and Wingery behind both benches. Neutral zone draw upcoming since it was a Kent State player that was down on the puck. Awkward collision there. Trying to move forward is Bennett. Staying with it is Luckhart. Knocked hard into the siding. Marks delivering deep. Whacking at it is Luckhart again. Staying with it is Clary. A hard hit delivered there to Ed Miller. Bodies flying here in the late stages of this hockey game as it's picked off. Nearly a chance for Luckhart, but couldn't quite catch up to it. Kent State speeding, but forgot something there. Buck was behind Soderstrom. Looking to weave across, taking a blow to the head there was Nate Owen. Finally airmailed deep by Kent State as we enter the final minute of the hockey game. Bulldogs looking to hang on to their 10-2 lead. Highlighted by a hat trick performance by Ryan Pinho. The man wearing the C. Marks shrugs his shoulders at the check from Corlew. Now he knows not to mess with the 6'5", 260-pound Owen Marks. This one lofted out. Checks continue to be exchanged. Tempers continuing to flare. Just 30 seconds until the final horn sounds. Will Smith has two goals tonight, and he's all smiles. In the third period at Arrington Ice Arena, thanks for joining us. Calvin Keyes narrating the action for you here on Adrian College TV, a broadcast run exclusively by Adrian College students. Briggs Blake's pass took an odd carom, a chance for Kent State. Shot deflected off of the stick of Sanchez. Bench raising up a cheer, still 13 seconds to go. Plenty of stoppages here in the final minute. Final minute that has felt like somewhat of an eternity. Again, Adrian versus Culver Academy in women's hockey action upcoming. Bulldogs looking to deflect it out. Sent wide to Goldberg's left. Kent State will maintain their hold on it. As the clock dies down, and the game will finish 10-2. Bulldogs take it by an 8-goal margin in their home opener. Everyone will mob Rex Goldberg by the Adrian net, and it's well-deserved as put on a 29-save performance. Bulldogs win here at Arrington Ice Arena. Thank you for tuning in here to our broadcast. On behalf of our entire crew, I'm Calvin Keyes. Stay tuned for women's hockey action at 7 p.m.
Adrian College Television would like to give a big thank you to our sponsor, Carlton Lodge of Adrian. Carlton Lodge is sponsoring all ACTV broadcasts during the 2021 to 2022 school year. Located at 1629 West Maumee in Adrian, Carlton Lodge offers comfortable rooms and suites at affordable rates. There's also a heated indoor and outdoor pool, along with a 24-hour fitness center. Thank you for the continued support toward Adrian College Television.